We are the faceless, and Jorgen is one of us. What is your question?
The Mother Namteru withers and dies. We know that something was stolen here, and we believe it is the cause of her sickness.
Nothing was taken. You ask the wrong question.
What question must I ask?
We do not know. We know only that you must ask it.
Archon Belgeth, patience. The Faceless know no truth. All we need to learn is floating here around us.
Patience, I have aplenty, but time is running short, and I have important business in Al-Betil. Vayne, I'll let you deal with the Faceless and leave you to your fate.
Ah, I'm beginning to understand that you always have.
Guardians, what have you forgotten?
Had only Sandro chosen a different path.
So, Vayne, you're telling me the Mother Namteru is sick because Sandro stole Ash's memories of the Wars of Creation from the Invisible Library?
I was hoping it would make more sense to you than it does to me, but yes. There was also something about returning the spider to the place she was born.
It does make sense. The Mother Namteru is an avatar of Asha, an emanation of her nightmares, born from the pain and sorrow she felt during the Wars of Creation. As for bringing her back to her birthing place, I'm the one that found her and unchained her from her madness. I'll be your guide. Prepare a good ship. The journey will be long and dangerous.
You should leave the bird behind.
It's a good suggestion, Bluebeak. Someone must look after Anastasia.
They've closed the doors. Sandro has been through here disguised as me once again. He has me wishing for angel powers, a staff or sword that could cut through his dupery.
Thank you.
come in a myriad of varieties. All of them are unpredictable.
I'll send a dozen ghosts and see if diplomacy is an option, or if I must kill them all.
The deceitful! You have two faces! One who murders, and one who talks of peace! Tongi will see your false tongue nailed to a tree!
Sandro has been here. They're expecting me.
It makes little sense to try and negotiate with an orc. He'll never believe what he cannot see.
I've become Sandro's Reaper, finishing the battles that he provokes. He shall pay for this.
Thank you. Makani vows before clan ancestors to crush Vayne's skull and wear his teeth as a necklace!
Sandro's treachery has made me yet another friend.
The bones of orcs make for good skeletons, but their souls make for poor ghouls.
I won't make ghouls of these warriors. They're not criminals. They're simply victims of the void.
You keep saying that Sandro is another lord, but you've not said how you intend on fighting a magic that creates rifts in the veil and holes in our minds.
We start by remembering the courage of the dead. This Makani deserves a headstone, and I shall give her one.
Lord Vayne, the Mother Namtaru has been moved safely into the fort. I shall stay with her to help her prepare for our journey to the spirit world. But we are now vulnerable. Defend us. If the Mother Namtaru were captured, it would mean the death of us all.
Told me the dragon nexuses house enough power to summon spectral dragons from the spirit world. I need dragon bones to use as anchors, but I know where to find them. The local pirates decorate their ships with dragon skulls.
Thank you.
Well, well, Craghack, my old friend. You never could stand the idea of being forgotten. Now, what treasure are you pointing to?
Thank you.
Captain Hack. I suspected that your ghost would have trouble leaving a treasure behind.
Captain Vane, what a pleasure to see you. Some necromancer friend of yours cursed me over some dragon-forsaken gold. A little nest egg I had hidden away for my granddaughter.
I should be able to assist you if you're ready to pass on.
No, that wouldn't do. My soul has been cursed. If I'm released the wrong way, I'll be eaten by the void. I need to find some poor fool who'll steal my gold for me.
And inherit your curse. You make it sound enticing.
Then I had myself thinking, what's a little dark curse for a Death Lord like yourself? Wouldn't it just bounce off you like rain hitting sails?
Well, I guess I could always use a little gold.
There's a friend. Now, there is the little matter of a few guardian creatures.
You are free of your curse, and I have gladly inherited it. But it will have little effect. The void fears me.
Ha! I always knew you were something more than a windsword, Captain.
Can you tell me anything about the wizard who cursed you?
Aye, that's easy to remember. He didn't have any skin on his face. I thought he was smiling and enjoying my jokes, and then he cursed me for no good reason at all. No sense of humor, it turns out.
You've had an incredible life, Crag Hack. You old bastard.
Yes, I have. And I'm planning on making the next life even better. Good luck finishing up your own story, Vane!
Long ago, to appease the suffering of the dragon goddess Asha, wounded by her memories of the wars of creation, her daughters Malassa, dragon of darkness, and Shalassa, dragon of water, built a magical river through the void, so her pain might flow away in dreams and her sorrow be healed.
Yes, you already told me this story. It is the foundation of the spider cult doctrine. The mother Namtaru was born from those nightmares.
What is important is that void magic was used during the ritual, and also to hide the cradle of sorrow, so that no one might remember that the rite had been performed.
I still don't understand what Sandro is after. Does he want to destroy this cradle or undo the ritual?
Both, I believe. He understands their primal resonance. The way that the ritual and the cradle and the mother Namtaru are one with creation.
Speak in terms even a skeleton would understand.
Sandro is here to erase the first echoes of the mother Namtaru's memories in the very womb where she was born.
Beautiful island. How ironic that it should be the stage of so much pain and suffering.
I must tend to the Mother Namtoru. Protect this town, for she cannot protect herself.
Why don't you join my army, Ghost? How can you resist me?
Tohunga not a ghost, Reaper. Tohunga is a shaman, father of Hunapu. And Tohunga asks service. Free Hunapu's soul.
And now the dead give me orders?
Tohunga offers treasure.
I hope your reward is worth my time, Ghost. Tell me what I need to know. Speak your peace, Ghost. Why have you not passed on to your dragon?
I am Yume, once priestess of this island, and now guardian of its sorrow.
I know your story. Your soulmate became corrupted, and you were forced to fight him or see his madness released upon the world.
I know you, Reaper of Souls and Slayer of the Nethermancers, lover of the Hierophant, and friend turned foe to the shadow of death. You too have made difficult choices.
Enough formalities. Speaking of Nethermancers, have you seen any recently? The spider weaves and she's running short of silk.
A Netherlord controls the Nagas here, as the Mother Namtaru once did. They are lost and bitter.
I have found the Cradle of Sorrow, Ludmilla. Prepare the Mother Namtaru.
Would you like me to deliver the spider in easy carrying pieces, or would her head suffice?
I can smell your fear, Ludmilla. What gave me away?
Lord Vayne left us with a code, and you seem to have forgotten it.
Join me. I have more to offer than a tired cult praying to a sickened spider. Secret codes won't protect you from me forever.
Thank you.
believe that that panther cub was a reincarnation of an orc?
Who knows? After all, the souls of the orcs are different. They don't belong to Ash's natural order. They were not created by her, but by the wizards. And they're torn between order and chaos.
We're not so different from them, after all. We're also a wizard's creation, an anomaly on Asha's perfect web. Maybe I'll reincarnate myself as a bat after I die the final death.
Who knows, Vane? Asha moves in mysterious ways.
Brother in death, Lord Vane, the Reaper of Souls. I know why you left Belgeth. I left him for the same reasons. His eternity was a lie, his immortality a prison.
Thank you.
The dragons have bound your destiny to their will. It is an illusion to think you have a choice. This reality is a lie. You know this, Vayne. You know the secret of the void. Wipe this world from all our memories in one final dark night. No more frail fears, no more hapless hopes, no more dreams unfulfilled. In the emptiness, we will be our own gods, and we shall make our own worlds. Thank you. brother in death, join me. Together, we will bring an end to this masquerade, this parade of dragons pretending to protect us. They built us to serve them. Their magic is our prison.
Again, Lord Vane. Or have you forgotten our last encounter?
I remember bringing your miserable existence to an end.
How appropriate. All existence is miserable, and indeed must end. But why do you refuse to walk the path of the void?
I will not let Sandro or anyone else destroy this world.
Do you know why you are not ill, Lord Vane? Why you are immune to the sickness?
I am old, turned by Belketh himself. I will be the last to fall.
Lord Vane, you were the first to taste the forgetfulness of the void and survive it. It was you who first showed us its true nature. You have the power of a Netherlord. You could write your own reality.
Thank you.
that which is dead. Let me be the one to write the epitaph on her tombstone.
Bring me Zakara. It is time.
Zakara has already made her choice. She's one of us.
She is much more than that. She has no destiny, nothing written on the web. Sandro made her this way without realizing it. Zakara is immune to the powers of the void. She alone can lead us into the Cradle of Sorrows.
So what now? Do we just wait?
No, we must go there. It will not come to us. You are welcome to join us.
You're asking me to cross over into the spirit world and relive the wars of creation?
No, I'm giving you the opportunity.
You know what choice I'll make. I'll be damned. I'll be damned.